San Francisco was responsible for a new trend in new pop music. And the Jefferson Airplane was one of the groups that made that sound popular. They really made it popular. Marty Balin, Spencer Dryden, Jack Cassidy, Yorma Calgon, and Paul Kantner. And of course, Grace Slick. Ladies and gentlemen, Jefferson Airplane.
As I can get it, Lather's supposed to be me, but it's more of a compendium between me and Jack.
You know, you'll have to talk to Grace about that. I really don't know. You know, you...
Does Lather have words? No, I'm just kidding.
You'll have to talk to Grace about that. She might be able to fill the end a little more.
Spencer Dryden was the oldest member of the band, and he was turning 30. And we had that whole thing about after you're 30, you're dead kind of deal. So, I called him Lather because he used a straight-edge razor at the time, I believe, and had a fairly thick beard, because he used Lather. So Lather was 30 years old today. They took away all of his toys. In other words, you can't be the same when you're 30 on as you did before that. You got to grow up. Lather still finds it a nice thing to do to lie about nude in the sand, putting fingers on either side of his nose and humming the best that he can. Spencer was very childlike. He's more childlike than the rest of the guys in the band, and they were all younger than he was. So it's a song basically about Spencer Dryden, being the old guy but still being a child.
I don't know, it's a weird song. You have to attach your own little things to it.
Lather was 30 years old today. They took away his his toys. His mother sent newspaper clippings to him about his old friends who stopped being boys. There was Howard C. Green, just turned 33. His leather chair waits at the bank. And Sergeant Dow Jones, 27 years old, commanding his very own tank. But Lather still finds it a nice thing to do, to lie about nude in the sand, drawing pictures of mountains that look like bumps, and thrashing the air with his hands. But wait, whole Lather's productive, you know. He produces the finest of sound, putting drumsticks on either side of his nose, snorting the best licks in town. That's all over. Lather was 30 years old today, and Lather came foam from his tongue. He looked at me, eyes wide, and plainly say, is it true that I'm no longer young?
Mommy?
And the children him famous, what the old men call insane. And sometimes he's so nameless that he hardly Beckham. Knows what Beckham. Game to play, which words to say.
Evie.
And I should have told him, no, you're not old. And I should have let him
I like shock value. Doing something that people don't expect is always an interesting thing for me.
Jean-Luc Godard, famous French filmmaker, you know. So he called us up, asked if we would meet with him.
We were all stoked about working with both Penny Baker and Jean-Luc Godard.
Jean-Luc Godard just came with a proposal of, I'm doing my thing, could you do your thing? You know, it wasn't scripted.
And I walked up, I said, well, what do you want, you know, with us? And he looked over and he just went, I want you to play on that rooftop over there.
We were taken to this hotel. I don't know whose idea it was not to get a permit. You know, I think that was maybe part of the whole thing, to take us up on the top of this hotel in New York City and play some songs real loud, live.
We had the sound system on there and it was just like hitting against these skyscrapers, you know, it was just like this gigantic, you know, the voice of Metropolis, people of Metropolis. And I looked over and I was going, hey, free music, you know, free love, you know, and then we started playing.
Jack's bass, bum, 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 bouncing off the buildings. All of a sudden, there were thousands of people in the streets down below.
And it was so loud, you know, it was midday Manhattan
or
something like that, that it just stopped traffic on the street, and huge crowds began to form down below on the street, and this aggravated the police, and they had to arrest somebody, and I guess Marty got in the way, and he was the one that got arrested. Or maybe they said, who's the leader of the band, and we all said he is.
It was an extraordinary afternoon in New York. I think it was sort of cold.
Freezing. Freezing to death.
Jefferson Airplane filmed this in 1968, and I guess it's a form of flattery because the Beatles did it in 1969. They filmed the scene on a rooftop when they did the album Let It Be.
I guess they got a lot of it on film. That must have, I don't even know, was the film ever released?